Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Patrick and we will write some code today. I did this tutorial already in German and then I thought, well, maybe you can try it in English too. So here you are. This is the tutorial in English. What are we gonna do? We built a REST WCF service in ASP.NET with Visual Studio Express 2012 for web, as you can see here. Why are we using an ASP.NET web application? Well, it's simple. It's just easy to use and you get a lot of stuff out of the box with an ASP.NET web application, for example, a complete login system. And for me, it's fun. It's just fun and you get results real quick. So let's just start right away. We press File, New Project. And here at Visual C Sharp ASP.NET Web Forms Application, it's Web Application 7. Yeah, we leave it. We don't want to save this. We leave it at the default settings. And as you can see here on the right side in the Solution Explorer, we have all the files we need. And what I did now is just show you the finished web application. Again, right click web application and then view in browser. And then your default browser will open and you can see you have the web application already done for you. It is already working, even the login system is working. You can create an account, you can log in, you can change your password, you can do everything you want to do with the login system. So that's the nice thing about ASP.NET, but we want to build a RESTful WCF service. So what am I going to do now is first create a new folder. And we call this folder service. Simple. Okay, the next thing is we right click at the service folder and then add a WCF service. The entry is here for us. Isn't this nice? Yeah, we call it service one. This is okay. So now we have two files here. First file is the interface, and the second file is the implementation of the methods you wrote down in the interface. The new thing are these attributes. These attributes just say, hey, this is a service and I want to communicate with this service from the web. It's a contract. Okay, and now here the implementation. The method doWork does nothing at the moment. And another important thing is when you right click at the service 1.svc file and click at view markup, you see the markup, but I will tell you something about the markup in a few seconds. The next thing to do is we need a web config. So right click, add web configuration file. Yes, call it web config. And you can see that there's not much to see here. We have a web config, but there's no content. Why do we need a web config file? First thing is, if we build the WCF service, then we have a finished, a usable SOAP service right away. But we don't want to use SOAP because we need then XML, or we transfer XML packages through the web. And these packages have a lot of overhead we don't want to have. So we use a REST service in this case. And with the REST service, we transfer or we transport JSON packages through the web, which is plain text, plain strings, what you will see in a few minutes. And well, it's just lightweight and modern and cool and all this stuff. So this is the reason why we want to use this stuff. Okay, for the web config, we have to write a lot of stuff. And I am real lazy because it's just a lot of work to do. So I prepared this stuff. We have the web config here, and I will paste this web config in the description of this YouTube video below so that you can copy and paste this stuff too. So what we have to do then is we have to replace these little texts here. Why did I do this? The reason is that YouTube don't let you enter less than and greater than signs in the description. Okay, so we copy it, less than, and now what I do is press Ctrl, Shift, and F. Then we go to Replace in Files, we paste less than and we want this sign. We look in the current document and we replace all 37 occurrences. Nice. Okay. Second step, greater than. Same stuff again. Greater than, replace with this sign. Look in current document, replace all. Also 37 occurrences. Okay, now I don't like how this stuff is formatted, so we press Control, hold Control, and then press K and then D, and hold Control all the time. And as you can see, this stuff looks nice now. Okay, then, well, this is the web config. I will tell you now two things which are really important in this web config. These are the names here. As you can see, we have the service name and the service contract. And yeah, this is from an old project. That's why here you can see web application 5, service 1. In the web config, you have to tell the service where the service is to find and where it has to look for it. So we go to the interface. Yeah, so you can see the namespace here, which is called Web Application 7 Service, and our interface is called iService. So we go to the web config and we see the contract. The interface is the contract, and we have to put the exact texts here. So Web Application 7, not yes, this way, we have application 7 service and the class iService 1, and we do the same thing for the implementation file, which is web application service and then service 1. As you can see here, namespace web application 7 and then service, and the class is called service 1. And well, one thing I struggled with was I renamed my service 1 file to just service. The problem with this is, if your namespace is also called service, nothing works anymore. Because, I don't know, I don't know why it doesn't work, just Visual Studio doesn't like this. So you have to rename it, and be sure to not rename your namespace with the same name you call your class. And yeah, that's it for the web config. The other thing which is really important, if you change any namespace or class name, you have to write it down here at the markup. Yeah, maybe a bit complicated with the web config file, but that's it. That's the most complicated part of all the stuff. Okay, we are done. We save it all again, and now there are only two steps left. We need some more attributes, and the attributes are here again, copy and paste, and you can see it in the description of the YouTube video. First of all, we put this here, the ASP.NET compatibility requirements have to be allowed, and next is, well, I would say the most important part. Well, it's not the most important part, but this is where we can find our method later. But first, ASP.NET compatibility requirements allowed. Visual Studio doesn't know what's going on here, so we have to click right at this text, resolve, and use the service model activation reference or library. And it's a shame we don't have a resolve here, so we have to add a new reference, and the reference is can be found here. Right click, add reference, and we need the reference, which is called System Service Model Web. Okay, and now we got the resolve entry, use it, and the thing works. Okay, web invoke, what is written down here? There are exactly four methods to use with RESTful web services. I only use two, and these two methods are first get and the second is post. And get just means that you want to get something from the web service, and post means you also want to get some information from the web service, but you give them information first. You know, there are parameters in the methods and you want to send them to the service and then you get something back. But we will do the post method in another tutorial. We just use this thing here now. Okay, next is the response format, which is JSON in our case. There is also the possibility to use XML, but we want to use JSON. The body style, this time it is bare. This means that you get the plain text this method returns. And wrapped are other possibilities. This just means that you get an object where this is just, well, it says it wrapped. But more about that in another tutorial. Okay, and the last thing, well, this is really important, the URI template, I don't know how to pronounce this, the link, I would say, how to call this method is do work. You can write anything you want there, but, well, I recommend to call it the same name as your method. Okay, do work. This is all the things we need for the service configuration. We have the web config here and we have these two attributes here. Okay, now we want to get some information from the service. Our do work method. We leave it at the do work method, but I want to return a string, so I change that. And again, I change it here. Save it. Yes. Okay, and we return a simple string. You guessed it, hello. No, we call it hello rest.cf service. Okay, that's it. This is our service. We build it now. Again, we can use this way, or we just open our browser. Okay, and now how to get to our service? I don't know. Maybe we can just look in our folder service and then we call our service 1. Great, this is the Dienst. Dienst is just German for service. Service 1 is working. We can communicate with our service. This is a nice thing. I was really happy when this worked for the first time. Okay, and what to do now to get our function, to get our method? We put in the link. Do work. Great. Hello rest.cf service. That's it. That's it for the rest.cf service in an ASP.NET web application. I hope you liked this little tutorial. Sorry for my language. I hope you could understand me. And I'd really appreciate it if you click the like button if you liked the video, and if you write any comments, no matter what you write, if it is a bad comment or a nice comment or whatever, and of course, please subscribe, then I would be your new friend. Thanks, bye, I'm out, and happy coding!